Hello my friends, my name is Artem Voronov, I'm a lighting designer and certified DIALux EVO trainer. In this video I'm going to show you how to make this soft cove lighting for bedroom. This is bedroom, and in this video I'm going to share with you how to make this room and also how to make this cove light. As you can see here, we have some bed lights and we have some spotlights, and how to add these lighting I'm going to share with you in other tutorials. Okay, so first of all, let's start and let's open our new DIALux EVO instance. Here we're going to import our JPEG plan. So my plan is here. Okay, let's import it. I'm going to share with you all the files I have in this tutorial in our Telegram channel. This is Lighting Design International community. I'm going to share with you my files here. I'm going to put the link in description of this video. Here we have our drawing. We have bed here. We have some low shelves, windows, and two doors. Okay. First of all, let's put some initial point of coordinate system. Let's click on the first point and on the second. Okay, and here we're going to add our scale. Scale here, we have in DIALux, we have in meters, units, we have meters. Okay, let's put here 0.77. Enter, and let's finish these iterations and go to properties in this plan window, sorry, in position, and make sure that you have 0 degree in your rotation. Okay, and then let's go to save options and click to this checkbox embedded plan in project. Okay, so go to the second point and here we have, and to this third point and here we have draw new room. Let's click on this and let's make our room contour. First point, second one, this one, and also this one. Right click and close polygon. And then we're going to hide our drawing, or we're going to open up it using this button here, display plan. Also, you can use F7 button on your keyboard. Go to Windows and let's click to select, and in this window we're going to add standard window. Let's drag and drop here. Okay, and use the scale button to make this window wider, and let's drag and drop next window here, and using this red arrow, it's very important that you drag to this with this red arrow. Okay, and then we should go to doors. We have doors in the same window. Okay, let's drag and drop it here, the first one. Okay, and use this scale tool to add a little bit another size, and also this door here. Okay, finally, if you go to story and building construction, you have some story height. Let's put here 3 meters, so we have 3 meter height of our ceiling. Yeah, and if you go to this 3D rendering view, you can see our room. And then let's add some 3D objects. I'm going to furniture and object, go to catalog, and in my home furniture I have some objects with the bed name. Yeah, we have here bed 1. Let's drag our bed 1 here. Okay, let's rotate it using this blue dot. And let's move it right here. And also, if you use the scale tool, you can achieve that size that you want into your project. Okay, here we have some low shelf, and also we have some shelf here. Let's go to object, use cube. Okay, and using the scale tool, let's give it some another size, and this is 1 meter height. Okay, let's make 0.4. Control C, Control V, and then let's make the same low shelf here. Okay, to draw this object, we should use this extrusion box. Let's drag here. Okay, and we have this button here, edit polygon. So as soon as I click here, I have some dots and I have some edges, and I can make my custom shape of my extrusions. Let's drag it here and let's put some new dots here. You should click on the right mouse button, and then you can add some new points here and here. Okay, go to this point. Nice. And we have some round corners in our project. This gives a more realistic view to the whole project. Let's put some points here. Don't add too much round corners, because it will load your computer, so you can have much longer time of calculation. Because this is a very small project. Usually we work, when I make consultations and when I make projects, I work with much more complex and much more big projects. So I can have like maybe in 10 times more rooms. So that's why you should make it more effective. Okay, so make the size 0.3, and I'm going to add some human. Okay, 0.1, 0. Okay, here, and I wanna make it more gray color. Yeah, this one is perfect. So if you go to furniture and object, click on this hero and then move it. Okay, so here we have some room. Let's save our project. So I'm going to share with you my file in our Telegram chat, so you can use mine or you can make your own from scratch. Let's start to make some cove lighting. First of all, you should go to ceiling and click on insert ceiling into room. Okay, now we have ceiling. Let's put here 2.8 meter height, and we should click this checkbox. So this checkbox close our polygon, and we should put here wall distance 0.15 and side offset 0.15 as well, and ceiling thickness we should make 0.012, so which is quite thick. And then we should make some lighting here. To start making lighting, you can go to any producer page and download photometry. I'm going to put this link so you can download it as well. Let's go to this characteristic folder and click to photometry. Usually I use this Ledstrip for cove light. So this is 2035 LEDs, 3000 Kelvin color temperature, and it's about 120 LED per meter. I like maximum capacity, so this is about 15 watt per meter. So you can use the same one or you can use any LED as you want. So first of all, we should go to this top view, then we should import our ES file. So I'm going to drag and drop it to DIALux EVO like this. Okay, now our ES file into the program, and I'm going to delete it, and I'm going to click on draw line arrangement and click on the first point and click on the second point, and I'm going to use this alignment, the second one, flush with start or end point, and I'm going to add here about 4 lunar, and I'm going to move it a little bit to the edge of our ceiling here. I see this ceiling polygon if I go to construction and ceiling. Okay, I'm going to use this polygon edit line tool, and I'm going to fit it right into our ceiling niche position. Okay, that's one nice. Okay, and then I'm going to front view, I'm going to move this LED strip, and I'm going to rotate it. Each luminaire is 1 meter long LED strip. It's comfortable if you want to then count luminaire quantity to make specification. Okay, let's copy it and move to another side. Ctrl C, Ctrl V, rotate it, and let's move it to another side, to this side, and let's edit this line, make it another length. Okay, so I'm going to click right on the last point on this arrow and then drag it to the right. Okay, and I'm going to put here 5 luminaires. I wanted to fill gaps between these modules. Okay, let's check in ceiling view. Okay, we have this LED strip right into our niche here, and let's start our calculation. And then I'm going to use some white balance slider, make it more warm. Okay, in this video we made from scratch our calculation for bedroom with cove lighting. So next videos we're going to put some bed lights, some spotlights here, and I hope that you like this video. Give a thumbs up, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and all the files you can find in our Telegram channel, and also you can communicate with another international lighting designers and that people who loves lighting design as well. Here I'm going to put a link below in description of this video. See you in the next video.